Dear friends, we welcome you to this presentation on water homeostasis and polyuria. Water, as you all know, is the most precious fluid. Any planet devoid of water is totally lifeless. So, water is the elixir of life, the amudam, the amrutam of life, the immortal fluid. Let us look into the mechanisms of water homeostasis and the derangements of it that cause polyuria.
प्राणापानव्यानोदान समाना भवित्यसौ प्राणः स्वयमेव वृत्तिभेदात् विकृतिभेदात् सुवर्ण सलिलमिव.
This is about the fivefold life principle. We call it as Pancha Pranas. We will see the meaning of this particular slokam from the Viveka Chudamani by Sri Adi Shankaracharya. The meaning is in the next slide. What are these five pranas or Pancha Pranas? The first one is called the prana, which is nothing but the respiratory activity. The second one is called the apana. Apana means digestion and the urinary tract. These are the excretory functions. The third one is the vyana. Here, vyana means the circulation or the cardiovascular system. And the fourth one is the udana or the nervous system, both motor and sensory. And the last one, of course, is the samana. Samana is the metabolic equilibrium, that is keeping the temperature constant, keeping the blood pressure constant, keeping the pulse rate constant, the levels of sodium, potassium, magnesium, urea, creatinine, glucose, water, whatever you name. This is to maintain the milieu interior at a constant equilibrium state, and that is the samana. In those days itself, they know that the life principle is composed of five different functions and five structurally different regions of the functions in the body. That is why they have said prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. Bhavitya asau pranaha. These are the five pranas. Svayameva vritti bedhat, because of the functional or physiological differences. Vikritir bedhat, because of the anatomical or structural differences, they are classified as five. But they all are nothing but the same vital energy. Just like the gold is the same in all ornaments, the water is the same in all containers. So this is the message of this. In this particular presentation of ours, we are interested in looking at the samana or the equilibrium, particularly the equilibrium or water homeostasis related to our subject polyuria. First of all, we will see how the water balance is maintained, and then we see how it will be disturbed in disease to produce polyuria. Today's topic is polyuria. We will see what are the mechanisms that produce polyuria, what are the different disease conditions that can lead to polyuria, and what is the differential diagnosis of polyuria. Based on the diagnosis, the treatment has to be tailored. But before we understand polyuria, we need to understand the water homeostasis. Of course, you don't need any introduction of the speaker. I only remind you to just see our website www.drsharma.in. And if you have any queries, you can write to me at the email address provided here. Our website, as you know, contains not only this presentation, but all the previous presentations and CMEs of mine in a chronological order. I request all of you to take advantage of whatever that is available on our website and write your kind feedback to me so that we can improve and move on from where we are. Let us see the next slide.